Hello friends, in this video we are going to study about the larvae of echinoderms. So it belongs to the phylum Echinodermata. There are total 5 different classes in Echinodermata in which we will study about their larvae. The first thing is that the majority of echinoderms have indirect development with the larval stage. So jo reproduction hai, the formation of an adult do not take place very directly. So yahan pe ek indirect formation hoti hai, the metamorphosis occurs and the larval stages forms. And why this occurs? Because their eggs have very little yolk and develop in the sea water. So bahut kam yolk hota hai aur sea water mein develop hote hain. So isliye yahan pe metamorphosis hoti hai aur indirect development hoti hai with the larval stages. Next thing is ki jo zygote hai, that undergoes a holoblastic, which means nearly equal radial and indeterminate cleavage, producing a ciliated blastula. So jab hum dekhenge in case of reproduction, to zygote first of all when undergoes the cleavage, it forms the blastula stage in which the cells are very much divided and ciliated, and the zygote shows the holoblastic radial and indeterminate cleavage. And that blastula further changes into the gastrula. Now the gastrula jo hai, that all the surface of the gastrula is also covered with the cilia. So the cilia that covers the surface of the gastrula uniformly become restricted to a large perioral band which surrounds a concave area near the mouth and the ventral side. So ab jo gastrula stage hai, wahan aas paas jo hai bahut sara cilia is present all around it. But when it comes to the further development, which is cilia head, that becomes restricted to a particular part, and that particular parts are perioral band and the adoral band. So in dono bands mein cilia jo hai, gastrula jo aaspas, jo gastrula ke aaspas hota hai, that becomes restricted. So in this diagram we can see this is the perioral band. So this is the larval stage, and this dark line represents the perioral band, which is the restricted area and of the cilia which covers the whole gastrula, and the next one is the adoral band. So a large perioral band which surrounds a concave area around the mouth and the vestibule. So here we can see this is the mouth, and this is the esophagus and stomach, and all the digestive system is present over here. So it surrounds near the mouth and the vestibule. So here we can see that the perioral band surrounding the mouth and the all other parts. The next thing is a small adoral band. This adoral band that lines the mouth. So adoral band jo hai wo mouth ke aas paas hota hai. So yahan pe the adoral band lies over here. So yahan pe adoral band hai, this is the perioral band, and these are the restricted areas of the cilia. So yahan pe jo hai cilia present hai. Now with all these changes, jab jo gastrula ke andar ye changes aa jate hain, bands present hona start ho jate hain, the perioral band and the adoral band, then with all these changes the embryo becomes a larva. So embryo jo hai wo larva mein convert ho jata hai because it is capable of independent existence. And the perioral band of cilia, ab yahan pe jo humne perioral band diagram mein dekha, this perioral band of cilia, it is it helps in locomotion. So ye locomotion mein help karta hai, it shows the clockwise rotation on the surface of the water, and it feeds on the unicellular algae, aur unicellular algae pe ye feed karta hai. Now jo adoral band hai, jo perioral band hai, wo locomotion mein help karta hai, and jo adoral band hai cilia ka, that helps in attracting the food particles towards the mouth. To wo khane ko attract karne ka kaam karta hai. So these are the functions of the perioral band and the adoral band. The perioral band helps in the locomotion, while the adoral band helps in attracting the food particles towards the mouth. So the thing, another thing is that ki jo larva hai, we can see this larva, it has a bilateral symmetry. We can see agar hum ise do mein divide karenge, to shows the bilateral symmetry, and this larva is known as Dipleurula larva. So is larva ko Dipleurula larva kehte hain, aur we can also say them as the Echinopedium larva. So it is also called as Dipleurula larva or Echinopedium larva, and it is the fundamental larva from which arises the various types of larvae of Echinodermata. तो ये जो डाइप्लूरुला लार्वा या एकाइनोपेडियम लार्वा है, दिस लार्वा इज द फंडामेंटल लार्वा, क्योंकि ये जो है हर एक क्लास में There are total 5 classes of echinoderms. So, her class mein jo pehla larva banega, jo fundamental larva banta hai, that's the dipleurula larva or echinopterium. और इसी लार्वे में से आगे चल के बाकी सारे लार्वे बनके निकल के आते हैं. सो दिस इज द फंडामेंटल लार्वा फ्रॉम विच राइजेस द वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ एकाइनोडर्म्स लार्वे. लेकिन जो एडल्ट फॉर्मेशन होता है दैट शोज द रेडियल सिमेट्री लाइक वी सी इन केस ऑफ स्टार फिश. इट शोज द रेडियल सिमेट्री बट देयर लार्वा विल शो द बाइलेटरल सिमेट्री. सो दिस इज द थिंग दैट देयर एडल्ट शोज द रेडियल सिमेट्री बट द लार्वा शोज द बाइलेटरल सिमेट्री. Now, the various types of, in various classes if we see, the larvae of various classes differs in shape, size, number and arrangement of arms and number of ciliated bands. तो अब जो larvae होंगे अलग-अलग classes के, वो vary करेंगे shape में, size में, number कितने हैं उनके अंदर, मतलब कि कितने larvae बनेंगे, दो बनेंगे, तीन बनेंगे, and arrangement of arms and the number of ciliated bands. These ciliated bands helps in locomotion, like perioral band and the adoral band, like that. So, यहाँ पे we can see there are total 5 classes and representing different larvae other than the dipleurula larva which is the fundamental larva. The first class we are going to study about is the Estheroidea which consists of bipinnaria larva. The second class is Holothuroidea which consists of auricularia larva. The third class is Echinoidea which consists of Echinopluteus larva. The fourth class is Ophiuroidea. Ophiuroidea which consists of Ophiopluteus larva and the fifth one is the class Crinoidea. This class Crinoidea consists of crinoid larva. So these are the total 5 classes and their larvae other than the dipleurula larva which forms the fundamental stage. Now the first larva is the from the class Estheroidea which is the bipinnaria larva. So after the formation of dipleurula larva, yahan pe class Estheroidea mein bipinnaria larva hai and this is the diagram of the bipinnaria larva. Now the bipinnaria larva has a large preoral lobe. To ye jo jagah hai, this is the preoral lobe, not this, yahan tak. This is the preoral lobe. So the bipinnaria larva has a large preoral lobe and it gives off 3 arms. 1, 2, 3. The bipinnaria larva has a large lobe and gives off 3 preoral lobe. The bipinnaria larva has large preoral lobe which gives off 3 arms and this is a ventromedian and a pair of preoral. All directed forward. तो एक ventromedian है, दो preoral arms है, and they all are directed forward. So these are the 3 arms of the preoral lobe, right? Now the sides of the larvae also bears a pairs of arms. तो जो larvae के दोनों side पे हम देखेंगे, so it bears a pair of arms. The first one is the anterodorsal arm. This is the anterodorsal arm, posterodorsal arm. Posterolateral arm and posterolateral arm. So anterodorsal, posterodorsal, postoral and posterolateral arm is present. These arm gives off its larva its name bipinnaria. There is a prominent dorsomedian. So there is a prominent dorsomedian arm extending forward and is continuous with the anterodorsal arm. The next thing is that the perioral band is split into two. The perioral band jo hai wo do mein split kiya gaya hai, which is the preoral loop that borders the preoral lobe and its arms. The second one is the postoral loop that borders the remaining all the arms. So preoral loop ka kaam hai preoral lobe ko surround karna aur unki arms ko border karna, jabki postoral loop ka kaam hai to surrounds the other or to border the other remaining arms. So it is derived from the or divided from the perioral band. So perioral band divides into preoral loop and postoral loop. The next thing is that the bipinnaria larva later develops 3 fixing processes. अब जो bipinnaria larva है थोड़ी time के बाद क्या करता है, fixing processes develop कर लेता है. These are the fixing processes. So the bipinnaria larva later develops the 3 fixing processes or branchiolar arm. So this branchiolar arm on the ventral side in front of preoral lobe. So it develops the branchiolar arm in front of preoral lobe and The arms are relatively short. These arms are relatively short, without ciliated band, have adhesive cells at the tip and carry a sucker between their bases. So they carry a sucker between their bases. They have three arms. These three arms are relatively short, without any ciliated band, and they have adhesive cell. Adhesive cell ka matlab hai ki which attach to the other object very quickly, very easily. So they have adhesive cells and they consist of suckers at their bases. Now the bipinnaria larva, when jo bipinnaria larva jo humne piche dekha, so the bipinnaria larva, when it consists of the branchiolar arm, then it is called the branchiolaria larva. Jo bipinnaria larva ke paas jo hai hamare paas branchiolar arms present ho jati hain, uske baad isko hum kehte hain branchiolaria larva. So it is termed as the branchiolaria larva. The next thing is that the branchial area settles to the bottom. अभी जो branchial area है, it will settle to the bottom and attaches to some object and metamorphosis occurs in fixed condition. तो वहाँ पे जो है metamorphosis हो जाएगी in the fixed condition. So branchial area larva settles to the bottom and attaches to some object and metamorphosis occurs in fixed position. So this is about the class Steroidea, which consists of bipinnaria larva, which later develops into branchiolaria larva because of the formation of the branchiolar arms. So this is the diagram of the branchiolaria larva. Now if we see the second class, it is the Holothuroidea. So in class Holothuroidea, we see the larva Auricularia larva. So this is the diagram of the Auricularia larva. So yahan pe Auricularia larva mein we can see this is a very large preoral lobe, this is the preoral loop, and this is the postoral loop or the anal loop. Now in this case, what happened is that the Auricularia larva, jo hai, this is the transparent larva. So this is the Auricularia larva. The Auricularia larva is transparent, flagellated larva, about 0.5 mm in size. So ye transparent flagellated larva hai, jiska size 0.5 mm hai. It has a large preoral lobe. We have seen that it has a large preoral lobe like the bipinnaria. Its sides bear short pair processes which is supported by calcareous particles. So jinki sides mein agar hum kono mein dekhenge, they are short paired processes and it is supported by calcareous particles. Now the ciliated band is single. Wo jo dark band hai that runs all around, the ciliated band is single and the larva swims with the help of ciliated band which forms the preoral loop and the anal loop. So yahan pe this is the ciliated band. This ciliated band is single and it forms the preoral loop and the postoral loop. And with the help of ciliated band, they swims. So locomotion occurs with the help of ciliated band. Ciliated band is single and it forms the preoral and the anal loop. Now there is another thing, that a sensory flagellated apical plate is also absent, sorry, present. So ek plate hoti hai, ek sensory plate, apical plate jo hai inme present hoti hai. Now what happens is that the Auricularia larva later becomes barrel shaped. So kuch time baad kya hota hai ki jo Auricularia larva hota hai wo barrel shaped ban jata hai. It becomes barrel shaped and its ciliated bands breaks up into separate segments which later forms five ciliated rings around the body and is called Dolioleria larva. So here I show you the diagram of the Dolioleria larva. So this is the Dolioleria larva. Now what happens is that ki जो ऑरिकुलेरिया लार्वा है वो जिसके पास सिंगल सिलिएटेड बैंड है वो टूट के बहुत फाइव सिलिएटेड बैंड्स में डिवाइड हो जाता है, पेयर ऑफ फाइव सिलिएटेड बैंड्स, एंड बैरल शेप हो जाता है, तो तब उसको डोलियोलारिया लार्वा कहते हैं. एंड हियर वी कैन सी द सेंसरी एपिकल प्लेट विच आई हैव टोल्ड यू राइट नाउ. सो एक एपिकल सेंसरी प्लेट इज ऑल्सो प्रेजेंट, फाइव सिलिएटेड पेयर ऑफ सिलिएटेड रिंग्स and a barrel shaped structure is present. So this larva is known as the Dolioleria larva after we can say Auricularia larva. Now the Auricularia jo Dolioleria larva hai, it was also termed the pupa. To usko pehle pupa kaha jata tha jo ki abhi hai Dolioleria larva. The next thing is that the metamorphosis jo hai wo free swimming stage mein hoti hai. और जब इसकी मेटामॉर्फोसिस होती है इन द फ्री स्विमिंग स्टेज विच सिंक्स इनटू बॉटम एंड बिकम्स पेंटेक्टिला लार्वा. तो डोलियोलारिया लार्वा स्विम कर रहा होता है और अचानक से जैसे ही वो मतलब कि सिंक करता है समुद्र के अंदर, मतलब विद इन द सी व्हेन इट सिंक्स इन द सी इट बिकम्स द पेंटेक्टुलर लार्वा विच ग्रेजुअली चेंजेस इनटू एडल्ट बॉडी विच इज सिंपल ओवल एंड फुली सिलिएटेड. तो वो बहुत सिंपल होती है, ओवल होती है, फुली सिलिएटेड होती है और पेंटेक्टुलर लार्वा से ही चेंज होकर एडल्ट बॉडी बन जाती है. सो दिस इज हाउ द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ लार्वा फ्रॉम लार्वा टू एडल्ट टेक प्लेस इन क्लास Holothuroidea, in which auricularia larva we have studied, which changes into the dolulario larva, also termed as pupa, and after that it changes into the pentectular larva. Now, this is about it. So this is it, and in the next video we will continue to study about rest of the three classes and their larvae, which is the Echinoidea and Ophiuroidea and the Crinoidea. So I hope that you liked this video, and if you did, then please don't forget to subscribe, like, share and comment. Thank you.